Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azure Seas of Nether. I am Der Heizmeister, and this is episode 19 of the Quest for Nether campaign, season 2. I'm here in the designer, currently applying the finishing touches to the newest aircraft in my fleet. This is the PFA 205 Vampire, a heavy fighter. Yes, I have a little announcement to make before we start. Please bear with me here. Next week there will be another construction episode of a defensive emplacement. However, there will also be an episode of Quest for Nether. I have a little bit of time on my hands, so I thought I'd spend it wisely. Anyway, I have thought a long time about what to construct next, but I want to leave it up to you guys. Meaning, I will upload a poll in the community tab on YouTube, giving you four options to vote on. This will then determine what I'm going to build next week. The options are basically either an anti-aircraft gun, you know, like the last one, but much, much bigger and with a larger caliber. So a bigger boom, or a surface-to-air missile emplacement, well, a SAM launcher, so to speak. And the third option would be a saturation artillery system, using cram mortars, kind of like the system I have on the Thunderhead cruiser. And the fourth option is a rapid-fire kinetic gun used to target ground targets. So, I guess this poll should be up once this episode is out, and I am awaiting your votes. Anyway, let's get into the campaign. And here we are, back in the campaign. Now then, the Great Talons have been defeated last time, courtesy of the Jolly Roger and her flying company, though they are heavily damaged and need to return to base for repairs. So, what to do next? I think it is finally time
moving out
to, basically annihilate the Scarlet Dawn once and for all. They have no means of, coming back from the loss of so many resource zones. And I think it is now time to end it.
Listening.
So, we are up against the Scarlet Dawn itself, their mothership, and a Magneta, a resource Listening. Collector. So then, let's position the fleet. You are still called Airship Prototype. Why are you calling it? Anyway. Alright then. Let's do this. Airfleet Phobos versus... Whoops. My frames, no. Versus the Scarlet Dawn. I can't believe I'm starting with the main event right away. Anyway, Andoria Aero Corvettes, destroyers, have already been launched and are on their way to the target. Here are the Magellan frigates. I just had to think about what kind of ship this was. I forgot the class of ship right there. And you're in the water again. How nice. Might be called an airship, but you're not meant to float on the water, that is. So, what do we have here? A Magellan Resource Collector. I think you have seen it before. Now, it is dead. And there she is, the Scarlet Dawn has just spawned in. This is the mothership and subsequently the HQ of the Scarlet Dawn forces here on Nether. And it seems it has caught these Andoria destroyers out of position. Oh no, it has spawned in right behind them. Oh boy, and here come the lasers. heat missiles, getting a few strikes off there. Nicely done, but these lasers are going to be a real trouble, since none of my airships are equipped with any smoke dispensers. Some do have shields though, only that is not sufficient to defend against a laser assault. And, oh, I see. These blue lasers are probably controlled by anti-missile cannon controllers, these Sievers controllers, and they act as, active defense systems. Well, that is clever. Since sometimes it can be beneficial to use normal laser emitters instead of LAMPS nodes, as LAMPS nodes have a quite a damage fall-off with distance. Anyway, oh, particle cannon, strike, and doesn't look like it has done so much damage here. It's still active, and the air fleet is struggling to catch up to it. We had to leave you behind. Ooh, no, don't zoom me around the battlefield. One Magellan Arrow frigate has been downed. The Scarlet Dawn is still airborne. And the weather is... very bad. Yeah, it's tanking quite a lot. Though I have to say that these airships are more of the lighter type, save for the Andoria destroyers. Maybe I could bring in some torpedo boats as support. Who knows? Maybe I'll have more luck with those. Yeah. You know, if you would actually hit the Scarlet Dawn, then that would make things a lot easier. Though, as it seems now, the Scarlet Dawn mothership is, well, relatively unharmed. Oh, yeah, 92%. Still. Here come the Vega torpedo boats. Let's see if their air-to-air torpedoes can cause some trouble for the Scarlet Dawn. Apparently not. They got intercepted by the active defenses. Alright, nice. I mean, not nice. Yeah, now we have Magellans pulling alongside the Scarlet Dawn. I hope they can get a few shots off with their side-mounted weapons. One having particle cannons and one has a... what's it called? A low caliber APS. There goes the particle cannon. Nice. They should be set to piercing. This is one of these adaptable type particle cannons I have set up so that when the enemy has a large volume, they will be set to piercing, and when the enemy has a smaller volume, they will be set to impact. Speaking of impact. Doesn't look like it's supposed to behave like this now. Goodbye, my friend. He who crashes in the mountains has no place on the battlefield. And what happened to you? You have no materials. Did I honestly forget to... Hang on a minute. Yeah, it's not doing much good now, is it? Anyway, the Scarlet Dawn has joined the Andoria destroyers beneath the waves, and I'm fairly certain this is it for the Scarlet Dawn. I'm afraid your invasion has been cancelled. It's still not below 80% and sinking, though I can... There we go. Yep. This is it. The Scarlet Dawn have been defeated. I will leave a small group in their territory to clean up their resource zones and claim them for myself, and then basically deactivate them. And that will be it, I guess. Bye bye, Scarlet Dawn. And here we go. We will not go into the night without a light source. Yes, with the enormous wreck of the ancient starship smoldering in the water, that is true, the plague that has troubled Nita is finally over. But I'm still here though. Ha! Any survivors of your wrath have scattered to the wind, and those that aren't caught by your troops will soon succumb to the hostile environment. Whether you are a liberator who has finally freed the land from an alien incursion, or a psychopath who has committed genocide, not going to comment on that, on an entire species is irrelevant, exactly. All you know is that there's only room for one planetary conqueror on this world. Finally. Wait, I have to prepare for battle again? I just finished one fight. Oh, what do we have here? A Shadow Cat is blockading what is essentially my rapid response force. Nah. So, with the Scarlet Dawn defeated and the Steel Striders basically close to defeat, they have three headquarters left. At least these are the three headquarters that I can see right now. I think it is time to wrap things up here. Now, before we do that, however, it looks like the battle group surrounding the super battleship Caledonia are in a bit of a pickle. Receiving. So, I will send in Task Force Mars to do what is necessary. Ignore the pop-up right here. This is something for later, not now. Ignore it.
Receiving.
Yeah? How about this? So, Task Force Mars coming back fresh from the dockyard, refilled and retrofitted. And I'll be on the Orion. What do we have here anyway? An Arrow Tyrant. Ooh, nice. Do I have anything that can... I don't think so. Those are mostly destroyers. Some frigates. Yeah, maybe the missile frigates, I don't know. Anyway, this should be interesting. Let's do it. And all the ships have spawned in. Man your guns. Here we go. What do we have? What do we have here? We have something fortressy looking. What are you? A Revox munitions factory. And a Cat Shark. Small frigateer being instantly, well, basically gutted by those large heat torpedoes fired by the Scipio destroyers. Now, this lone Shadow Cat here is now coming under anti-aircraft fire from all sides, and even some cram cannons. Well, at least they tried. And what's next? This installation is still up and running, it seems. Okay. One installation down. Let's see what will be spawned next. Probably the headquarters? Yeah, judging from the lag, it might be the headquarters. Yeah, there we go. Nothing else? Nope. No Aero Tyrant? Anyway, this is the Iceberg Logistics Hub. Looks like some mobile dockyard there, brimming with guns and mimics, it seems. Very nicely built. Very sturdy though. Yeah, shame I have to take it apart now. One of my Agrippina frigates is in trouble. The engine has been taken out and she's now dead in the water. Let's have a look here. What exactly has happened? Let's do a bit of damage analysis while in battle. Oh yeah, it looks like a direct hit to the boiler room has taken out some of the steam boilers and the batteries, including electric engine. I see. I will keep that in mind for future builds, to have maybe not one central propulsion room, but rather two separate rooms with two separate sets of batteries and electric engines. Redundancy is important when it comes to protecting your ships. So, after a initial barrage, it seems like the guns of the Iceberg Logistics Hub have fallen silent. What has happened? I assume that the EMP charges hidden in the missile payload of my ships have fried the local weapon controllers and basically rendered those guns disabled. Very nice. I was saying that. Oh, yeah, what are you? Agrippina, type 2. Getting torpedo hits. Well, at least you have two guns that are still firing. Although that lean is getting very dangerous, I have to say. But still, the fleet fights on. And this is it. The headquarter of the Seal Striders, Iceberg Logistics Hub, is now despawning. Or basically falling apart. Okay then, I wonder what's next on the field. I have to assume that it's going to be... yeah, the Aero Tyrant, most likely. Well, no sign of the Aero Tyrant just yet. There is a Lynx, a Shadowcat... no, wait, it's a Retribution, a Shadowcat and a Cat Shark. Not the big boy yet. The big boy is not on the field. Oh no, wait, that's another helicopter. I forgot the name. Anyway. Cat Shark has once again been gutted by heat torpedoes and is dead in the water. Very nice. I do love my heat torpedoes, after all. They are very, very useful, especially when fired downwards from a ship. And they then come up beneath the target and basically expel their heat fragments upwards through the ship's bottom. And the Kantak cruiser is finishing the job by totally annihilating that Retribution. So, what do we have left? A Manatee! Yeah, that's the name! Right, I forgot. This is a Manatee. Now, a dead one. So, I guess now it is time to... ha! There we go! The Aero Tyrant. A very deadly gunship slash bomber. And this will probably cause a lot of problems for my fleet. However, every missile and every bullet that I can currently fire is now headed towards the Aero Tyrant. Yep, there we can see a few missiles trying to catch up, but not catching up in time. Turn around, and this missile strike there has to be from the Murray, Razul's little support ship. Not to be underestimated, by the way. This one, the Murray, is basically built to disable enemies and make it easier for the remaining forces to deal with any high-value threats. Spams a lot of missiles, though. And... nope. Not today. No missile strike today. The Aero Tyrant is still very much mobile. However, it looks like APS gunfire has now... yep. That was the main cannon. And... there it goes. Though seeing how some of my ships are lying dead in the water, it seems this battle has taken a toll on my fleet, and Task Force Mars may have to return to port for some repairs. Nothing to see here. Move along. Just a few terror leeches eating up a sacrilego. This is a little surprise I prepared for another force. However, it seems they have to make do with the sacrilego for now. These are basically nukes, but better. They are equipped with a simple weapon drill, a few rams, and a desire to lodge themselves into the enemy and eat them, completely eat away at them. I called them the Terror Leeches because this is, by definition, a perfect terror weapon. They also harvest materials as they eat away at the enemy, which they can distribute to other forces. Hence, why I called them leeches. And there goes one down. Aww. But yeah. May I present to you my newest addition in the category What Was I Thinking? / Smoking? / Drinking? The Terror Leech. Soon on the workshop, I guess. Moving on. Once again, it is time for a battle to be fought, but this battle shall be fought beneath the waves. My submarine forces...
moving out.
And one intercontinental ballistic missile are now being engaged by a few Steel Strider forces. We do have some surface contacts here. A Victoria, two Victorias, a Typhoon, another Typhoon, and a Panther.
Receiving.
So, a few submarines and two ships. Alright, where's this Hermes? There we go. I'll be comfortably sitting on one of my favorite submarines, the Type 4, and I'll experience the battle from there. Alright then, dive, dive, dive. Here we go. Let's see. Yep, swarm of torpedoes is in the water. Holy shit. I might have overdone it a little bit. Just saying. Yeah. Have fun. loot. Anyway. Typhoon. Now being chased by... way too many torpedoes. That one was a heat torpedo. And this battle should be over shortly. If only this Hermes ICBM wouldn't try to basically engage a submerged target. That would be rather nice. So... wait, you missed. How could you... Oh, right. I'm an idiot. I have to give the correct commands to the ICBM. Where is it? Where is it?
Engaging now.
Engage it. Engage the surface contact. Come on. I just hope I selected the right unit. Yeah, it seems like it. Okay, then. No, I didn't. Whoops. Yep. That's it for the nuke. That right there. That's a dead nuke. Oh. Right. Button. So, with the typhoons dissolving in what can only be called heavily, or highly concentrated torpedo soup, delicious, I can now focus my attention to the surface contacts over here. Most notably, the Victoria. Does it have torpedoes or any kind of missile defense? It does have Seavis on deck. Four of them I can't see right now. Though, will it be enough? I wonder. Probably not. Yep, here are the torpedoes and detonating because they have completely run out of time. Oh, nice. One turret popped. However, the Victoria is still in combat. And this is how it looks like beneath the waves. Fairly comfortable sitting here on the Type 4. There are two Type 4s hugging. And here's the swarm of torpedoes impacting on the Victoria. Now, I originally constructed this force, or let's say this submarine, the Type 4, to deal with the black current. However, it seems that surface contacts in general are, yeah, absolutely no problem for a mass of so many submarines firing so many torpedoes. They do, however, tend to burn through materials quite quickly. That is one of the drawbacks of using so many weapons, as well as an injector engine. Highly inefficient, but powerful. Oh, and I think I mounted a steam engine on there as well. Yeah, all the power, and for what? Just to spam missiles, or torpedoes in this case. That doesn't feel right. Is effective, though. Okay, what do we have here? Well, while there's nothing to see here, it looks like another Victoria has spawned in and is now firing away with its close in defensive systems. I forgot what the acronym of Seavis stands for. Close in weapon system? Yeah, close-in weapon system, that's it. Trying to defend itself against missiles and torpedoes currently en route to their target. Oh, there they are. I just thought, where is the mass of torpedoes? Yeah, those are small torpedoes. Not doing much, just chipping away at the outer armor and delivering a mild EMP charge. I was just confused for a second. Oh, there we go. Large torpedoes with heat warheads, certainly effective. The two missing turrets of the Victoria can basically testify for this. And what is that? Oh, a nuclear torpedo trying to catch up to the Victoria. Yeah, good luck with that. At least it should be possible, at least until the engines have been taken out. Seriously? This is just... Please tell me, is this too much? Kaboom. Probably is, because the nuclear torpedo just got hit by friendly fire. Yeah, it feels cheap at this point. So, in an unusual streak of fairness, I have purposefully beached these Type 4 submarines to give the Victoria something to shoot at. Yes, that is totally the story I'm going to roll with. Nope, those are not vertically launched ballistic missiles, those are torpedoes. With the Victoria finally succumbing to an ungodly mass of torpedoes, I can finally say that this battle is finished. Exactly. Look at this. Is this too much? It probably is, yeah. Now, you may have noticed that the Type 3 wasn't spawning any more Hermes ICBMs, and there's a reason for this. The spawner has reached its limit, and I should now basically repair this issue by retrofitting the Type 3 into... Give me submarines, the Type 3, into itself. This resets the spawner, and I don't need to do any shenanigans in build mode.
Moving now. Listening. Moving out.
There we go. I was mistaken. I said earlier that there are 3 Steel Strider headquarters left, and yet there is the Damascus. A 4th headquarter that I did not notice. As well as a submarine pen. Very interesting. Liberator cannon, Revox ICBM facility. Wait, hang on. Those are structures that are supposed to be on land. Huh. Anyway, looks like I'm being blockaded right here. So, Task Force Jupiter has finally caught up with the rest of the fleet. They started all the way down here, captured a few Steel Strider tiles, and defended themselves against incoming Steel Strider attacks while taking out their resource zones. I mean, the Steel Strider resource zones. So, I guess it's time to put them to use. But against what? Alright, change course. Head west and join up with the strategic bomber squadron, and they will then be taking out this headquarter as well as the Watchmen. While the superb battleship Caledonia continues on its course north. That is at least the plan for now. I guess this will be the last fight for this episode. Task Force Jupiter and the Strategic Bomber Squadron versus Steel Strider Headquarter OCDS Engineering and the Watchmen. Let's do this. And a Falcon. Oh, let's not forget the Falcon. What are you? A Manatee. Oh well, we'll take you as well. Or maybe not. No, maybe not.
Listening. Moving out.
I cannot catch the Strategic Bomber Squadron to the battle if I engage the Manatee as well. There we go. Much better. Starting out, let's start out strong with Battleship Cerberus. And... wait for it. Here we go. Battleship Cerberus. 1 Scipio Destroyer and 2 Alligator gunships are now online. And they have to deal with... oh, those emplacements here first. They look dangerous. They are dangerous. Those emplacements are the Watchmen. Let's target those here first, please. Otherwise, they're gonna shoot down my helicopters. I don't want that. Ah, looks like 1 alligator has already closed the range. I mean the distance, and is now successfully peppering this Watchman here with low caliber APS cannon fire. Though it has shields, I see. Anyway, the sheer amount of okay. I was about to say the sheer amount of fragments should make up for that. However, yeah, large caliber heat guns from the Cerberus do speak an entire language entirely. I mean another language entirely. Okay, let's see if I can get the next Watchman here to go down as spectacularly as the first one did. Meaning in a large explosion. Yeah, evade those missiles, use your superior agility, and definitely not your luck while maneuvering. Yeah, see, it works if you set your mind to it. You can do anything, even evading missiles. Yep, you are correct. Those are indeed mushroom clouds in the distance. I didn't notice the launch of a few ICBMs heading towards the fleet, though they have been dealt with. Thankfully, the Cerberus anti-aircraft defense is still intact. So, looks like those defensive emplacements have spawned in. The alligator gunships are doing whatever. They shouldn't be trying to tip each other over. This is... Do I even need to say anything? We have more ICBMs in the air, however... Oh no. Oh no 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 no. The Cerberus failed to intercept them, and the result is a large chunk now missing from the Cerberus. That was painful. And here comes the second wave. Ouch. Oh boy, this battleship is taking a pounding. And number three. I have removed the Cerberus from the field. The Cerberus was still fighting, let's be fair. It was still operational. However, I wanted to bring in three different units for the volume that the Cerberus has just freed up. These are the ROC strategic bombers, and they should make short work with all the targets here in the area. Most likely the buildings here, these lovely little houses, and the remnants of this ICBM silo. And probably even the headquarters that will appear at any second if enough targets have been destroyed. And here comes the carpet bombing. Ah, yeah. Another Steel Strider headquarter has been pounded to dust. And I think this is going to be it for this episode. Three headquarters for the price of one episode. I guess that's a good result right there. And with that, I would like to say goodbye from the Azure Seas of Nita. I hope I'll see you next time when we will be, well, building whatever you voted on in the poll. And the battle is not yet finished and I'm still making my outro. Never mind then. Now it is finished. Okay. May I? Thank you. Well then, yeah, I hope I see you next time, and then we will be building what you guys voted on in the poll. Yeah, looking forward to it. Anyway, I am the Heizmeister, saying goodbye from the Azure Seas of Nita. Until next time, take care.